Welcome to Mars. Hints, such as this one, will appear throughout the training process, giving useful information. You need to master the camera controls and familiarize yourself with the Now it's time to land your first rocket. With the rocket selected, designate a landing site on the indicated location. And we have touchdown. The rocket has landed on Mars. Our rocket carries valuable resources that will be essential for the construction and maintenance of the colony. Initially, it's best to designate a universal depot so the drones have a place to store them. Along with metals, concrete is the other vital basic construction resource. Well done. Now observe how the drones will carry all the resources to the site and then construct the concrete extractor. Like most buildings, the concrete extractor needs power in order to operate. Having a reliable electrical grid and supply is essential for the success of the colony. Connect the Stirling generator and the concrete extractor using a power cable from the build menu to power up the extractor. Waste rock is a byproduct of all extractors and is best stored at designated locations. This way you can ensure that it will not be in the way of future construction. Drones will pick pending tasks on their own within the range of the drone controllers they are assigned to. Drones run on batteries that have to be recharged periodically. maintaining a steady supply. Don't have sufficient power for all the buildings in the colony. A system of pipes is used to deliver resources such as water and air where they are needed.
Resources are low.
Fuel production is now underway, and the drones will begin to deliver the fuel to the rocket. Thank you. Congratulations. You have finished the first tutorial. Welcome, Commander. In this training exercise, you will get acquainted with one of your most valuable tools. Now let's try moving around. The RC transport can load and carry resources around the map. Let's use it to refuel the nearby rocket. Now order the RC transport to unload the fuel next to the rocket. Thank you. Some drones are left without a controller after the rocket launch. The RC transport is able to gather resources directly from surface deposits without the help of drones. Let's set up a small expand some distance away from the main base. Nice work. Commander, one other thing. We need to construct a new sensor tower to scan the nearby environment. Good job. It's time to learn about scanning sectors and exploration. You can scan sectors of the map to discover new resources and anomalies. You can also queue sectors for scanning. Well done. Now it's time to use our fully operational RC Explorer to analyze the anomaly.
Anomaly found.
Good job. The anomaly has yielded interesting insights into new technologies. This is the research screen. From here, you can choose and queue techs for research. Commander, one other thing. Nice work. Now you know how to handle rovers. Welcome, Commander. It looks like this forward base has gone through a major dust storm. First things first, let's remove some unnecessary structures. Now, let's get that drone hub operational. We have some power, but it's not enough. We should prioritize the drone hub. We can use the machine parts left from the concrete extractor to build a wind turbine. Even with the wind turbine, there won't be enough electricity to power the base, especially during the night. You managed to get things operational, but this won't last, as buildings require maintenance, and we are out of resources. We need more metals to secure this base. Use the RC transport to collect some metals and transport them back.
Resources are low.
Good job. However, we need more than just metals. Fortunately, we can call a resupply rocket from Earth. Let's do some cleaning up around the base while we wait for the rocket to arrive. Now, let's remove some of the unnecessary cables. Supplies from Earth have arrived, and we can use them to expand the base. Water is essential for a sustainable Martian colony. Fortunately, there is a water deposit nearby. Use the build menu to construct a water extractor near the water deposit, then power it up. Water extractor is ready, but we don't have a storage for the water it will extract. time has finally come to build the first dome that will house our colonists. The dome is complete, but we have to supply it with water, power, and oxygen before we can use it. Thank you.
Resources are low.
Thank you.
Well done. You have completed the simulation successfully. Welcome back, Commander. In this tutorial, you will finally familiarize yourself with the challenges of sustaining a society on Mars. The foundations for bringing your first colonists have already been laid down. One of the final things left to do is to provide the founders with living space. With all preparations complete, the colony is ready for the arrival of the founder. From this screen, you can inspect all available applicants and determine which ones will travel to the colony. You may want to review and hand-pick individual candidates for the founders. Colonists will arrive on Mars with a small amount of food, but it will not last long. We need to make sure that they will be able to produce their own food on the Red Planet. The hydroponic farm can produce food. Although the colonists can take food directly from a...
New colonists have arrived.
Full of hope and determination, the first founders have set foot on the Red Planet. Colonists need service buildings to keep them comfortable on Mars. The grocery that you already constructed is one such service building. Great. Now that you have a space bar, you can customize its work settings.
Thank you.
Healthy colonists at working age are able to fill any position, but how well they perform at a certain position varies between colonists. Work shifts, among other things, are a way to manage your workforce. The more shifts a building has open, the more colonists it will attract to work there. Buildings with higher priority will be allocated workers, power, and maintenance before others. With the research lab up and running, let's begin researching some technologies. Congratulations, you have provided everything needed for a successful founder stage. You have completed the tutorial for the founder stage. Welcome back, Commander. In this tutorial, you will manage a larger colony that consists of multiple domes. Shuttles can transport resources and colonists across great distances. Thank you. Now that we have operational shuttles, it's time to establish a mining dome. There are no colonists in the mining dome. We must provide living space for the colonists so they can move there. Don't forget to provide basic services for the citizens of your new dome. You can set up filters for every dome to attract colonists with desired traits, and block or push out colonists with undesired ones. Being near a rare metals deposit, this dome is best suited as a mining hub. So it's best to encourage geologists to migrate here. This dome has been designated for research purposes, so it's best to attract more colonists with the scientist specialization. Colonists can migrate between domes using shuttles or walking when they are positioned close to one another. However, they cannot usually visit buildings in nearby domes on a daily basis. construct two farms in the new dome. They will be used as workplaces for the colonists in the old dome once the domes are connected. Domes positioned closely to each other may be connected with passages. Good job. Some buildings can have upgrades that
crop failure reported.
No. Congratulations! With the research complete, a new upgrade for your extractors is now available. It is not automatically activated in your buildings. You must construct it first. Nice work! The upgrade has been constructed. Thank you. The command center is a treasure trove of information about the colony. Congratulations, Commander. You have graduated from the International Mars Mission Training Simulation.